We were captured in the beginning of the system of white supremacy, and I have no record of when that began. It's argumentative, but I don't participate in arguments, so I try not to. But some people say 400 years, some people say 600 years, some people say at least 2,000 years. But you go back and you look at all of the records of the Roman Empire, all of the history of the Roman Empire, you see some black people in Rome. And they were what? Slaves.
Yeah.
They were taking the move to the Colosseum. So when you talk about white supremacy, it may not have even started then. It may have started way before then. Okay? So I say I don't know. But now, if you're talking about war, you're correct. War was declared against non-white people by the white supremacists before anybody walking around on this planet now was even thought about being here. So this has been a long-running show. And that war was, up to this point, won. Now the reason I say up to this point, and that the war isn't over, even though all of the non-white people come under the foot of racist men and racist women, the white supremacists, collectively, all, without exception, on the planet Earth, right this minute in 2019. But how do you counteract that? You counteract that with a code. And that's counter war. Because the war has already, you know, that part of the war has already been completed. I think that's the best term to use. That part of the war has been completed. Now, why do I say the war isn't over, even though all black people are in captivity? All, without exception. No black person walking the face of this earth who is not subject to the system of white supremacy. And if anybody finds one, I want to know where that person is and who it is. And I want to see how they did it. Because that's impossible. In the system of white supremacy, it means all. It doesn't mean some black people are subject to the dictates of somebody white and being mistreated by that person who is white. It means all, either directly or indirectly, including all of the non-white people, all of the black people who have never even seen a white person, never even heard of a white person. They still come under the system of white supremacy. So that part of the war has been completed. Now, I didn't say the war is over. Why? Because you have things like this program right now, talking about it, talking about resistance. As long as you have people who are talking about resistance, it ain't over, all right? Because from talk will come action, you know? You can't talk about things without having the urge to act. That's just, you know, people use the act on what they're talking about. Somebody right now, I'll just give an example. Some black person, 16 years old right now, has got a couple of 9mm lying on the table before him. They keep picking them up and looking at them, loading them and unloading them, pulling back the slide. Oh boy, I can kill me somebody, all right? You let that 16-year-old keep doing that. You know what's going to happen? They are going to kill somebody. Now that's a guarantee. You let them just keep doing that, keep playing with that gun. You know, hey, I got to use this thing. I'm just sitting here playing with it. I got to go out and make this thing, you know, I got to see how, you know, what it looks like to see somebody fall down when I point this thing at them and pull the trigger. I got to see that happening, all right? See, whatever you're thinking about, you keep thinking about it. You're going to fool around and do it. That's the same way with practicing racism, and it's the same way with practicing getting rid of racism. You keep thinking about it, and the books that I have written are designed, and the program that I'm in now, hopefully, is designed to keep us thinking about it so we'll act on what we're thinking.